Hi, in this video I will present you with a major update for the drawparamLine plugin for 3D Studio Max, the plugin that allows you to create a parametric line using specified angles and length, and you can change the length at any time after creation. This version introduces additional features, the ability to create this line using two points, and also now you can load an existing line in the scene even after closing the dialog, and you can also use it to load a line created with the line tool of Max on one condition, that this line must have only two vertices. And the improvement regarding the first version, in the first version, if you add a modifier to the line and start modeling, if you try to change the length, the script was deleting those modifiers. Now you can keep those modifiers and change the length of the line. Also, you can load existing lines in the scene that has modifiers. The script will always look at the first entry of the stack, and if the first entry is a line, is a 2D shape with two vertices only, it can be loaded. So we will walk through all these features now in the video. We'll start with the first method already existing in the script. In the first method, you specify an angle, let's say 45 degrees on the Z, 45 degrees on the Y, and you click create. Now using snap, I'll click here, and you can see that I have a line with 45 degrees on the Z and 45 on the Y with this length. I can change it at any time. I can create another one, let's say Y0, or a vertical line with Y equal 90. You can change the last created line. Now the improvement regarding the first version, in the first version it was impossible to change the length with those, only the last one. Now if I can click this one, for example, and click load existing shape, and you can see the name and you can see its length here. Now I can play with the length. I can load this again. Here I will create a line using the line tool. I can click this button to load it. You can see its length, and I can play with the length to be sure that this is correct. 30, I can go to helpers, choose tape, and you can see it's exactly 30. Now for the two points method, first you need to activate it. The other methods will become unavailable. Here you need to click this button and choose two points using snap. I will choose this point here and here. Now you have this line pointing to this point here with this length. I can use and here you can see a readout for the distance between those two points here. If I want to have this length equals this, I can press this button, use full length. If, for example, I want this line to be half the distance, I can use a trick. I can select the number without this here, the centimeter thing, just the number, and copy, then click inside the spinner and use Control N to have this small calculator here. Paste the number, and you can divide it by 2. And the moment you paste it, this will happen. This number will be pasted here, and the length will change. Now we have a line that is half the distance between those two points here. If by accident you close the dialog, you can open it again. You can choose any line in the scene. Let's say this. You can load it and change its length. Now, let's talk about adding a modifiers. If you add, let's say, an extrude modifier, if you want it upward, just go to rotate and use local. The good thing about the script, here I will choose move and local, the pivot point is always aligned with the line. So when you go to rotate, local, using angle snap. Now it's 90 degrees. I can still, this is not loaded. Here, for example, even if there is a modifier, the script will look at the first entry. I will click load, and now I can change its length. I can add a shell, for example, or even before that, I can click here. I can do inset. Delete it, for example, and shell, and you can still play with the length. Also, using move and local, you can have copies parallel to its axis. Choose shift instance 2. And on the z-axis, And since they are instances, if I choose this one, the one that I'm working on, I can change their length. If I close, open, I can choose any of those, load, for example, here, if I choose one of those and manually, let's say I altered the orientation by changing the vertices, the vertex manually, what will happen, if I load it, you can see here the length, and the script will calculate the orientation, and you can determine the length respecting the orientation of the line, the current orientation. Also, I can use this tool to do some tricks. For example, here, using the first method, I will choose an angle of, let's say, 35 degrees for the Y only, and create line using snap here. I can choose this surface here, choose this segment, and I can snap it to here. So now I'm sure that this face is at 35 degrees and has a length of 80. So you can get creative on how to use this line on a mesh to determine the orientation and the length of certain segments. Last, this feature here, if it's checked, it will make sure that the pivot point is always at the starting point, the first point of the line, the first vertex. If you uncheck it, when you change the length, the pivot point will remain where it is. So anyway, so basically that's it for this video. Hope you like the plugin. And in the description below, you will have a zip file. You can extract it, and there is a readme file, that explains to you how to install it and how to use it. Also here in help, you can use this here, explanation. Also this will take you to my channel, and this will take you to my playlist in the channel on YouTube. So basically that's it. If you like it, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next video. Thank you.